tonight. But you're looking like a million, man. I'm happy.
No, you go to Murphy's and you just do what you got to do.
At least you can go. At least you can go.
Hug my dehydrated.
It's 10 o'clock.
Yeah.
Yeah, you probably.
I didn't do it.
Thank you. Thank you. it wouldn't be right.
Yeah, this is why we can't feel the other.
Yeah. Yeah. Give it up for so long, you know.
Okay, you can be seated again.
Said apple don't fall too far from the tree, huh? That was nice. That was real nice. My name is Johnny Perkins, class of 85. Man, let us pray. Dear God, we come before you right now. God, we thank you for the gathering of hearts and spirits. God, we ask that you dwell amongst us, so God, have your way in this place. God, we thank you, oh God, for the impact, JR impact in our lives, how he touched each and everyone through his music, through his care and his love. We thank you for the sacrifices he and his family made for us, that we might be changed in our futures. Bless us on today and forevermore. Amen. At this time, we're going to have a drill team tribute. Mr. Roberts, and while they're getting themselves together, where all the drum majors at? From 82, 83, 84. I go back to when he first came. All right, well, I was the best. I was 85. I still control a little bit. All right. 86, Corey Stewart was 86. 87, 88. 89, 90. 90 right there, drum major. What's your name, man? How you gonna be down there silent and a drum major? If you don't get, I'm sorry. All right, that was 89, 90, 91, 92, 93, 94, 95. All right, 95. All right, Will Butler. Well, I helped train him. That's why he took first place every year. That's right. 96, 97, 98, 98, Jim Walker, 99, 2000, 2001, 2, 3, David Hunter, Dominguez High School, that's right. We thank God for the man that he shared his talent. He went from West Compton all the way to East Compton. And man, it still touched people's lives and changed them. Some of us wouldn't be the leaders we are if he didn't yell, scream, throw chairs and books at us. Ain't that right? Y'all got some memories. Pick them up. Hit the track. Don't come in here with no food. How many people remember our little brother Jed? Tighten up. All right. Y'all ready over there? You're not ready? Okay. All right. Any drill team captains in the house? All right, we got Ivory. Got one up there. Amen. One over here. Look at all these Cincinnati. Man, the Cincinnati was a bomb. And man, the major rec was a bomb at. And I think they got rid of the song girls and you got all this. Y'all ready? Okay, they ready. Y'all. Let me see. Y'all remember when to celebrate? Don't be sitting here just looking. If you was in a band, you know to march, clap your hands, and do something, all right?
Okay.
All
y'all know JR, we were lined up over there by the cemetery, put all that stuff back there, put 10 cars in between us, because he didn't want all them drugs messing with his thing. One year he told us we're going to get on the bus.
Just a quick story of why I had a drill team on the program. When he first started working here at Centennial and got the band, he started as a math substitute here in 82. Then when he got the band, the first thing he needed to start with was some drums. He needed drums. So he going around school asking everybody who playing drums around here. And people he would talk to, they was all playing in park drill teams. Back then, park drill teams was like huge. Wasn't nobody playing, all the drummers in the band, everybody was in the park drill team. So after school, we had to practice in, like, no drums. And all they hear around the community is all these parks around here is doo doo doo. So he said, I'm hearing drums all around the community, why can't I have no drums? So he had to drive over to all the parks and make deals with all the park and the drill team directors just so he could have drums in the band. So that's how drums started with his marching band. So there's the story.
So just how we're gonna move along here, what we're gonna do, we're gonna have Jeffrey Moses come, a scripture reading. Right after Jeffrey Moses come, we're gonna have Jim Hawthorne come and pray. Then we're gonna do the Matthew comedy. Is that all right with that?
All right.
So where you at, Matthew? Okay, all right, we're good then. All right, let's
nor crying, neither shall there be any more pain. For the former things are passed away. Can somebody say hallelujah?
Hallelujah.
May God add a blessing to the reading and the hearing of his most precious and holy word. Amen.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
I don't know what that means. Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Come on, stand to your feet. We're going to reverence God in this place. Amen.
Amen.
We thank God for Mr. Roberts.
Yeah,
I was his drum major, assistant drum major 96, head drum major 99. He did that thing. He birthed us on. He made us men. He made y'all young women. So we want to honor him, amen?
Amen.
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 Father God, it's in the name of Jesus that we bless you all today, oh God. Father God, we ask that you send your spirit of comfort upon the people, oh God. But most of all, God, we ask that you show up for the family, oh God, when they're in their lonely nights, oh God. We ask that you be there with them in the midst, oh God. Father God, we ask that you ask your angels to put a hedge of a protection around them, oh God. Father God, let them know that you are their own, oh God. Father God, lead them and guide them in every way that you want them to be. God, we thank you right now, oh God, for the life, love, and legacy of John Roberts, oh God. Father God, some of us did not have fathers, God, but you saw fit that he be that need, oh God. You saw fit that he filled that death. God, we say thank you right now in the mighty name of Jesus. God, we bless you in this place. We shabbat you in this place, God. We submit to you in this place, God. We ask you for more John Roberts in this place, oh God. We love you. We decree right now, God, that peace will ride over the family. We decree right now, God, that love will ride over the family. And say, if you're listening, we certainly notice that you are already defeated. In the mighty name
Jesus. We speak peace, life, love. And everybody said amen.
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 Amen. Amen again. God bless you.
It'll be hard to follow that.
Right.
How are we doing out there, Apaches?
Yes.
Apaches! John's in Apaches. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I forget the range that, you know.
Yeah, it's some Don's in here.
It's some Don's in here. Yeah. Even though y'all in the home.
That's right. Right.
We hate
them. The
forgiven. And now, I mean, I graduated in 91. I was the drum major in 90 and 91. And it was great. You know, now time has changed a little bit. We're not as dedicated as we used to be. You know, the school spirit is not what it used to be. We used to bleed red and white.
Yeah.
We all bleed red. But Patrick bled red and white. Right? Yeah. And it was fantastic. Now, things have changed, and, you know, the Apache mascot is inappropriate to some people. It's not as inappropriate as a baby in a diaper with a knife.
Right.
I'm sorry. I'm a crack, a warrior. A warrior baby with a diaper. I'm sorry. I bleed red and white, so, you know. You're right. And we're all a family. We're all a family.
Yes, we are.
Music. We're a family. Thank you for having me, Michael. Michael was a mentor of mine when I was in high school. He was in the drum section when I was here, running it.
Yeah.
And I remember playing the drum section. I was in the trumpet section. We were great. We used to, our slogan was Trumpets Rule. And I remember playing the drums in basketball. And we used to compete all the time. It was great. Mr. Roberts changed my life like he changed a lot of yours. Because a lot of us, you know, my dad wasn't always there, but Mr. Roberts was.
Right. Sure was.
And when we showed up, that band room was a beacon.
Yeah,
no matter what was going on, no matter what riot, what fight, what shootout, we could go to that band room and we felt safe.
Yeah.
We felt safe. You know, it's good to see a lot of people that I went to school with, Denise, Dana, Stephanie, like a lot of people out here that I went to school with. And I'm proud to say I'm an Apache.
That's right.
You know, I may not tweet that. Because the Redskins are now in command. I'm proud to say I'm an Apache. You guys, wear the red and white. Keep going. Our drum majors, it's a long line of drum majors. I was trained by Monique and Toya, by Trayvon and Pedro, and then me and Vladimir got our chance.
Yeah.
And the Compton Christmas Parade.
Boy!
We keep everybody there. Y'all was all right. Y'all was all right. But Centennial, we came in, it was like, I remember coming down Compton Boulevard and looking back, and our band was so deep, and our drill team
Cincinnati cheerleaders. It felt like I was looking miles back. And I was like, all right. Yeah, right. Johnny, like, what? I was like, I'm about to do this.
Yeah, right.
And I remember Mrs. Roberts got mad at me because I was like, we all gonna wear shades tomorrow at the Christmas parade. And everybody showed up with their shades. And we won every year, right?
Yep.
And this year they were gonna dock us a few points because they were like, shades is not in your uniform. And I was like, come on. Still kicked that. Still did. Sorry, excuse my French. You stand up sometimes. Anyway, Mr. Roberts taught us so much about discipline.
Yes.
Remember the band uniform? Mm. Y'all clean. Awesome. And we couldn't get on the field unless we scrubbed those white shoes, polished them. We had a uniform like. We had a whole committee making sure the uniforms, making sure the hats was on point.
Yeah.
Mr. Roberts would raise money with the Booster Club to make sure we had the freshest outfits out there. I see the red and white jacket.
Hey.
We wore that on Friday.
We did that.
I couldn't wear that in my hood. I was in a crib neighborhood, but I didn't wear blue here.
Nope.
Never. But on Friday nights, white pants, the white shoes, the red and white jacket, we were a patch.
Yep.
No matter where we went, Mr. Roberts made sure we were professional, we did things right,
yeah.
We looked clean,
yes.
And sound great.
Great.
Impeccable.
Yes.
As far as it wasn't no, it was like tune up the band, make sure every instrument was on point. It was amazing.
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna miss Mr. Rob.
Yeah.
Because he changed my life. Like he changed a lot of yours. I'll tell you one story, because I was in the trumpet section. Remember Goldenberg Chicken?
Yes.
Oh, it was right across the street,
yeah.
Goldenberg. We used to get the chicken bits.
Chicken
right?
Bits.
It was like 12% chicken, 99% batter.
Yeah.
That's how it was.
1%.
They changed now. We were there all the time. I remember I was at the bus stop on El Segundo, proud with my drum major baton and my trumpet. 6'4" drives in front of me. Two grown men get out of the car, surround me, ask me what set I was from. Y'all, I was smart. You know I'm not gonna tell them I live in Mona Park. Right? I was like, I live down the street. They were like, where at? Oh, a little bit to, you know, I never told them exactly. And they got frustrated. They were like, all right, man, we're gonna take this. And they took my trunk. They stole my trunk. They didn't even know what a treble clef was.
Right? Come on.
Stole my trumpet. And that devastated me. You a man, you a guy from the hood, you got your horn. Somebody take your horn. And at the time, my dad had me when he was in his 60s, right? So I had an old man's dad. I remember calling my dad like, he took my trumpet, Dad. Come get me. Pick me up. And the whole ride around Compton, I tried to convince him that we need to do a drive-by on the people that stole my trumpet. I was like, you gotta get him, he took my trumpet, that's how I've been playing that since ninth grade. He's like, Matt, we can't kill people for your trumpet. They will get you another. You know, and I remember breaking the news to Mr. Roberts, because Mr. Roberts played the trumpet. It's how you think it was hard for you and Mr. Roberts, but when he played the same instrument as you, he was 10 times harder.
Oh, yeah.
Because you played what he played. And I remember telling him my trumpet was stolen. He was like, couldn't hit him with the baton? Not are you okay? Not I'm glad you're alive. You couldn't hit him with the baton, is what he said. But I know what he was saying. He just wanted us to be tough. be ready for life. And a lot of us that didn't have dads in the house all the time, we were a surrogate dad. It just was, you know? And I really appreciate you, Michael, for sharing your dad with us. Because you didn't do it. Michael didn't do it. Like, the attitude, he was like, man, this is my dad. He did it like, this. He's for all of us. And I don't remember Mr. Robert ever getting on Mike because he had the drummers on point.
Yep.
He never got on. I'm like, man, your dad is like Joe Jackson, but he ain't speaking. Yeah, I love Mr. Roberts. He worked with Barry White. Jose would be him. We had band banquets. We did all, we traveled all over. We were in UCLA, homecoming parade. We did so many things. And he opened my eyes to the world and taught me how to be a leader. And right now, I write for sitcoms, I write for animation. I write for Chris Rock. And the reason why I do it, you know, and the reason why I'm a leader is because of Mr. John Roberts. And I appreciate that. And I'm going to miss him just like all of you. Really, because he was hard. If he didn't cuss you out, he didn't love you.
Oh, yeah, you know it.
How many people in here got cussed out by Mr. Roberts? Thank you. That was his version of the prayer. That was his version. And he could get away with it back then. Man, I was called every MF in the world. But I played some higher notes for it though.
Yes.
I understood. He showed me, like, and he wasn't the type of teacher that was like, just play the notes. He taught us music. He taught us music vocabulary. I didn't know what crescendo, embouchure, all these things. He let us know he's not just going to teach us the fingering of the instrument. He's going to teach us how to read music. And he taught us. How many of y'all still know how to read all these years later?
Yep.
You still can read music. Literate musically because of one man. And Compton, I see this DJ Quick, High C, second none in High C was here when I was here. DJ Quick was at Gardena. I don't know what happened. I don't know if he got kicked out or what. He wasn't here. But he always would come and hang out here. And there's a reason why Compton has so many musicians and rappers that make it. How can such a small city have so many people that come from here and become successful? It's because music is in our blood. It's in our blood. And the reason why music is in our blood is because of one man. That man is Mr. John Roberts. And I appreciate every hour he put in, hours so much. I'm sure he spent some of your dinner money on us, Michael. Like, I appreciate all of it, man. And anything y'all need, I want y'all to put your hands together for Mr. Roberts. He was Centennial, Compton, legend. And we know John, who will never die in our heart. We love him. And thank you for having me too, my man. I appreciate it.
I have so many stories I can be here all day, but I have something to trigger. I want to say, I saw a lot of Major Rex in the early days. Major Rex, it was girls would just want to come, just shake some. You see a girl one time and looking pretty in front of the band and everything. And they would come all the time to him saying, I want to do that. I'm like, well,
Majorettes are a part of the band. So, you need to play something. I don't know how to read. I don't know anything. Nothing about music. I'm saying it's okay. They come out to school, you get some bells out. You see papers around CCC, BBB. So we're going to start just like this. He'll teach you a rhythm. Then before you know it, you're learning how to play music. But you could not be in front of his band, not know what was going on with the music. So once they started, I think a lot of them started with, I think it was When I Hear Music. And that's a great bit of life. That will carry his trumpet everywhere he goes. He would tune up the band right in the middle of the street. And when the band lost the morale because the football team ain't never done what they're supposed to. That's too many companies continue football. They came for the band, the drumming, the management, and the Cincinnati. Yes. And you would hear him in the stands, and he'd tell the bass drum, hit it. Boom, boom. As soon as you hear him, when I hear music, the band director would stand up and start drumming and clapping. And if one hit was out of line, John Rock would be like, kill it. That's it. So the next time we have a break, he would call up the Sentinels. He had zero tolerance for nonsense. He demanded the best of us because he taught us the best. I don't know about y'all, but in the 80s, we'd go home before 9 o'clock. We'd go home before 9 o'clock. And we still have to clean the bedroom.
Sure, yeah.
The way we found it and the way we had to leave. All right, so with that being said, he's taking us back to all the music he wrote in 1982 when he first came. He said, how am I going to get these black people to play? They played, and the beat goes on. All right, the Rock Rock and the Family Rock, the band will just drop down. Boom, 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 boom. And then the troopers will start rocking out. And what happened is because you played argue with it, the band began to grow. He went from asking people to be in the band to having auditions. Everybody wants to play the drums in
comedy. Yeah.
Cookie don't get into the band room, thought he was going to play the drums, and they end up blowing them too. Y'all didn't feel that horn.
Yes, yes, yes.
I don't make none of us out. He brought the best out of us. We never know what he was doing and why he did, but what he did and when he did, what he did made us who we are. I ain't gonna lie, I was the most two left foot drum major he ever had. I couldn't be music. I was on a student council. He said, come here. And he put a book in my hand, it was a drum major. After he put the book in my hand, he gave me a stick. He said, when you can carry this stick and march on beat, I think the whistle was first and third beat, I would do it second, fourth, and fifth. It took me a while to learn that. But he taught me after a while. With all that being said, I was the first drum major to leave Centennial and become the lead drum major in college at Lincoln University of Missouri. That was because of the name.
Didn't want to go to college at all. Grew up in Nickerson Gardens. So y'all know I had to fight in Harvard Park. Go up hunting just to get to the project to get back the next day. I would leave home at 6 o'clock to bypass the gangsters. But he made a difference in my life. At this time, we're going to have a poem. If you play the trumpet, just keep on blowing. All right?
Do you hear that sound? Do you hear that sound?
It would tell you.
You find a roadblock, listen to the birds and the bees, listen to the wind in the trees, and you'll find music. Do you hear that sound? Ushering him and guiding him and carrying him as he makes his transition. Do you hear him sounding in your heart? Do you hear that sound of his trumpet playing? You hear him, right? When you hear the sound of music, you remember John Robbins. When you hear the sound of a band, you remember John Robbins. When you hear your own sweet sound, what do you hear?
John Robbins.
Y'all hear that sound?
Yeah.
I hear that sound, the whistle blowing. Mm-hmm. And Mr. Robert carrying that bullhorn cussing you out because you ain't picked your feet up. Cussing you out because you doing the wrong note. Here we go. He come and sit in that chair. B flat console scale, warm up, let's go. There's somebody back there still playing around. And next thing you know, a book come flying out. We ain't never been baptized with a music book, but then you get to the point. I'm sorry, y'all, I got precious memories. I got so many memories, I came back in 95. I saw sleeping in front of the playroom. All right, here we go. At this time, I'm going to have a musical selection. Rap tribute by Alvin Pitts. So while Alvin Pitts is coming, we're going to get ready for reflections, all right? So let's keep it to 1 minute. All y'all in the church and the funerals. Five people. So any five people that got something to say, hopefully y'all not all from the same year. All right, so five people. All right, five people. So the first five, you can just come down and then we can go from there. All right? So at this time, I'm going to have a music selection. Right after the he gets through with the rap music, then we're going to have a, we'll start with the reflection. Now look, just what we're going to do on the tributes, on the reflections. Well, we have 2 minutes reflections. Now if you go over your time, I'm going to tell the DJ, drop it. Alright, drop it like that. So that's what we're gonna do. Alright? We wanna be conscious of the time. We're glad that you're here. But we wanna keep on celebrating. Here we go, come on.
What's up, y'all?
What's up?
I said, what's up,
y'all? What's up?
Yes indeed. I'm an old folk. Jamaica's down, baby.
That's right.
Now, we love the Apaches. Okay, I gotta say this before I do this song, because the song ain't too long. It was too emotional to write, so I couldn't get the whole thing out.
Okay.
But we know he started here with y'all, but then he came over to Dominguez, and then y'all got him back. Y'all sent me right back home like y'all said where it started from, right?
Yeah.
Oh, you can't hear me? Is that better?
Yeah.
Is that better?
Yes.
Oh, okay. All right. So I was
I was one of his problem childs, you know. I was the one that got cussed out a lot. You know, when I first came to the band, I was raw as they come because I lived, you know, a very, very street life. I was really into the gang life activity, for real. So he changed all that. Because we would go like certain places, and you know, when you in the gang, you can't go everywhere.
Yes,
so when we had to do the Pasadena parade, I say, Mr. Roberts, man, I don't know about this place, man. He said, what you mean? I said, man, well, you know my color background. He said, and he looked around, he said, yeah, you keep your ass. Keep your ass on this bus. So I said, okay, all right. And then there was a situation we had one time at the school. And he said, he called me off. He said, look, man, you know, I take my time with my students. I love y'all, you know. He said, but you got me kind of worried, man. Do I got to worry about my students or what, man? Because you're kind of dangerous. You know what I'm saying? I said, no. He said, okay, well, I ain't going to kick you out, but maybe kick your ass too. So, all right. I said, you got it. So that's my story, you know what I'm saying? I love Mr. Roberts. It was nobody else like that, never met nobody like him. So let's go, B.J. Turn it up. It's very real. This link right here. Woo!
Juju.
JR. That's what the shirt say, fly high, energy never die. Because that man put something in me and all of us that'll live on forever. You know what I'm saying? So thank you, Mike. I love all y'all. Thank y'all for coming, because this is all just an expression of what you did. Thank you for being so emotional, thugs from my team.
Mr. C. So I work with both of them. So what he started my first year,
I still see it now. So I'm teaching here now. So I graduated in 83. So I can come back years later, 40 years later, wow, and still see his progress.
Yeah.
Yes, I was a student from fall 93 to 97. The first time I heard the Centennial Marching Band was like in 88 at the concert. It was Christmas break. My older sister took me, and I can hear the cowbell, mm-hmm, right, coming down the street, mm-hmm, right? And the gentleman spoke about those shades. I remember that. Right, they were coming up and boop, and they put on their shades. And I remember Mr. Robert saying stories about that, how it's not an official band uniform, so they got some points to take a look. I think they still took first place?
Yep.
Yeah. Okay, so like many of the students, Mr. Robert left an everlasting impression. He was my musical father. I have a great father myself, and his discipline and expectations aligned with what was at home, so I call him my musical daddy. Yeah, I love him so much that I wanted his job. Yeah, I remember it took me a while to get my degree. 8 years.
That's all
to
right.
Get my bachelor's degree.
Yeah.
It's not a plan. It's like written out for you really well. You kind of make it as you go. But anyway, towards the end, I remember people call me every year. Hey, you got your degree already? You got your degree already? You need to come out here in Compton and teach. And I entertained the thought that I never really actually believed that I would be in the band room sitting in this chair. Wow. Also, I had to become like my own band director because his unorthodox methods from the 80s and 90s were not too compatible with modern times. Thank you. And I'm also very grateful for Michael. When I came to Centennial, I was terrified. How am I going to have all this? He said, hey, man, just take care of the horns, the music, and I'll do the drums, and we'll make it happen. And I always tell people, yeah, with me, the band, it's good, but with Mike and the other alumni, they helped out a lot in the beginning. We were great. We're absolutely great. So thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
97 is the best.
93.
Hi,
Rainisha.
Hi.
So my earliest memory for Mr. Roberts started, I think it was maybe 89. I was playing the trumpet at Davis Middle School. So I see on a Compton Christmas parade them playing Suck a DJ. And I was like, oh, I'm going to that school. One thing you do not do is come and tell Mr. Roberts that you play a trumpet. Whoever said that, he was like, oh, you play the trumpet, let me hear you. I said, oh, okay. And I'm thinking, he was like, oh no. You don't play the trumpet, you a majorette. For any of y'all who know me, know I probably was the most spoiled majorette Mr. Roberts ever had. I was up there by myself. Scotty, if you don't get it right, that was Mr. Roberts. If you the first person they see when they coming down, when everybody coming down, what you think he's supposed to be doing out there? Mr. Roberts, they had this sequins bathing suit thing. I used to always want to wear my shorts. Oh, you gonna wear shorts? Oh, what about when they see you coming down? And I'm like, oh, Mr. Roberts. But me and Mr. Roberts, I think our relationship was always an argument. So I remember leaving my 10th grade. And mind you, I only got in trouble when I was outside with somebody I wasn't supposed to be outside with. Every time I came back in, it was an argument. So I left. because of that person that went to Washington Prep High School. The only thing I kept telling my mom was, I can't even wear these colors. I'm not gonna be in the front of the band. Like, what is this? I can't perform here. I begged her to bring me back to Centennial. When I got back to Centennial, he had the majorette. I was like, oh, if I'm not the only one that I know of. Robert, me and him arguing. I said, I'm gonna be a cheerleader. He said, no, you're not. I said, yes, I am. I went to Tina. I was crying. I was like, Tina. He said, I can't be a cheerleader. Came back, Tina was like, you can be a cheerleader. But I mean, all the memories. The one thing I want to say is Mr. Roberts took the F out of fear for us and turned it into fun.
Yeah.
I know that all of us are able to stand in front of people without having fear. Yep. We can go down the street miles and miles and perform with no fear in us. The only person we feared was this man right now.
Right.
We were scared that you stepped out of me. Oh, no, right. That wasn't happening. Oh, your formation.
Formation, honey.
Man, but I mean, because of Mr. Roberts, they say that, you know, your memorial shows, look at all the people that are here even years later after him. And we still come back and perform. We still come back to Centennial, and it's only because of Mr. Roberts.
Yeah.
So I thank God for everything that Mr. Roberts instilled in us. And like I said, I don't have fear. Mr. Roberts instilled no fear in us. Thank you.
Barry White with John Roberts. And I feel so much better now knowing that I wasn't the only one to yell at. I was a grown man.
Right.
He cussed me out. Not some rehearsals, every rehearsal. When we rehearsed out of Barry White's house, we never had the violins then. So I wanted to play all these big chords and just, do my thing. Cursed me out every time, and I never understood. But by the time we would get to the strings, I start hearing the harmonies of the strings. Oh, that's why I can't play that 9. Oh, that's why I can't play that 6. So he was he always tell me, man, the stuff you play is so beautiful, but you gotta know when to play. So he was very instrumental, and not only did I play for him with Barry White, he also brought me along with his other band, the Soul Heritage Band. I played at his New Revelation Baptist Church with him. And the church I play for now is a result of the relationship with him. So it was just all of the music, the musicians that you guys, I have stuff in my heart right now that I remember John told me, And you're gonna have it forever because he knows how to get you to understand. And as a self-taught musician, I still can't really read, but I can record. But he gets you to understand stuff that you don't. So, I really appreciate the relationship with him and Mike. Man, we be brothers for life. So, just thank you everybody for coming, and John made a big difference. I wouldn't be the musician I am had not been for John. Thank you.
Yeah.
Okay, play it.
is wrong, play it loud. I won't know how to fix it unless you play it loud. He needs to know when you make up, you mess up, so you know how to fix your mistakes. Like, he made me feel like I matter, you know? He was a dad to me when I didn't have my dad. And then my dad came back in my life and he taught me how to embrace my dad. You know what I'm saying? When you haven't had him, they haven't been there. You're like, blank slate, baby. Blank slate.
That's it.
Right. Mr. Roberts, he had finally been. What's that? Brother Abraham had many sons?
Right.
Brother Roberts had many sons and daughters. For generations, it's been. Y'all have a good one.
We're gonna work with them, and then when we got tired, then the next group
that we worked together. And when Mr. Roberts, when we knew we were doing something, because all of a sudden he'd be like this, but he did this. When he was here, we was like, oh, we didn't got it now. We knew we was doing the beat, and then it was like beauty. It was love. We had pride. We came in, and when I hear the students now, they're like, continue, and I'm like, excuse me, okay? I need you to represent, because we represent Centennial, we represent Compton, yeah. And we did it so proudly,
yeah.
Okay? We represent the Dons, the Beans.
Yes.
And the Teens. I know, but, I did tell my client, Don, what? He went to the Beans when I wasn't looking, But I'm like, he said, go with one love. I said, okay. But I just want to say, this man was able to reach all different people and gave us all what we needed.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
And all at one time.
Yeah.
So just an amazing individual.
Yeah.
Truly going to miss you.
Yeah.
I'm going to keep this short. I'm Nikia. Everyone calls me Nikki now. I was a majorette. And I eventually became a teacher, an educator. And what I take away from his life and his legacy is that he always provided a space for us. Going in the band room, that was a safe space. We could talk shit, we could, let all our, troubles and cares, people talk to us. And as a teacher, I provided that space for my students. And I just encourage everyone in this room, you have children in your lives, provide a space for them so that they can be themselves, so that they can create beauty in the world, and so that you hopefully can tell stories about Mr. Roberts to them. Provide a space for the babies. That's all I got to say.
He is my musical father as well, and after I got out of high school, I really did research.
research and found out, you know, how big and what type of range Mr. Roberts had. So the Barry White, to him having his own albums, to where his son was playing, I found that all and I listened to it and I still have today in his car. So thank you again to Robert Dunn.
And we want to thank everybody for those kind words. Wow, so much history. So much history, so many precious moments. Right, at this time, I'm going to have a musical tribute by Jalen Roberts. Bad on his mind. If y'all don't know me, I'm his youngest son, Jalen Roberts. I'm gonna speak this up because I'm too tall. But the best way I can describe my dad is, if any of y'all ever seen that old Dos Equis beer commercial, the most interesting man in the world. That's the best way I can probably describe my dad off the top of my head. Yeah, my dad was a cool cat, you know, to say the least. I remember when we were little, he would be going out to run his errands and go to the bank or whatever, and he'd be like, "Dad, where you going?" He'd be like, going to handle some business. I just thought that was the coolest thing ever. I'm like, what kind of business he finna go in? But, you know, most young men that grow up with their fathers, they bond with their fathers through things like sports, cars, or like some type of manual labor building stuff, taking stuff down, that type of stuff. Me and my father, we bonded through music. You know, that was how we talked to each other. That's how we related on music. He's the reason I got a sax in my hand to this day. Today I'm gonna play a song, a jazz song that we used to love to listen to together. It's called Stardust by Clifford Brown.
Yes.
It was the last song that I ever got to play for him before he passed away. But I never learned it from start to finish. So I wanted to learn it from front to back and play it for him one last time. So, thank you. on it. Clap your hands again. That's the seed of his seed. That's his youngest son. We know it's seven. We know Mike does it. You can see now. Jalen does it. There's probably some more gold down up in there. Got something.
Before we move to the finale with the band, and I would like to say when they play, if anybody, any major reps, real team members, or whatever, they come out here and play, feel free to come on the floor. You still think you got it?
Yeah.
You still think you got some little something in the tank, you know?
Number 11.
Might be a little extra salt and stuff, but you know. I'm like, how are you going, man? was never going to conference. We don't have to worry about that. He hated Compton just like we hated Compton. So he would never go to Compton. They paid him $10 million. He would be like, no, I'm good.
Right. Okay.
But anyway, to finish on my DI people, when he came to me and told me about that, I was like, man, what are you doing? I mean, like, we've been in Centennial. What are we talking about? We rival schools. How are we going to do that? He's like, I don't know, but that's what we do. So I had to get my mind around it. So I'm like, well, we're going to change the music. He's like, it's about music. So why are we going to change the music? So I'm looking at music and said, John's thing. John's thing. So I'm tripping, man. I'm really tripping. So I'm like, at first, I'm like, I ain't going. So I said, well, okay, if you're doing that, I'm not taking Centennial Beats up there. We're not doing that. So I got there. I can't remember who. I think it was Cliff, Donnell. I think I had like three drummers. Breed, he was scared of it. He didn't want no parts of it. Because I said, y'all gonna have to stop playing Master Grip and go to traditional. He was out the door. He didn't want no parts of that. But anyway, I said, we're gonna have to play. I'm gonna make a whole new thing for y'all. New beats and everything. Because they was playing Compton High beats. That's what they was doing when I got out there. It was a beat that drove me crazy called 16. That Compton High beat, that they love. Every time I come around, and we plan that beat. I'm saying, I have to struggle with that. But to end, I'm so happy that I came up with something during the Roberts time that's still part of history at the biggest, which is Ready to Go. That is still an epic moment for me. In my heart is that beat right there.
Yes.
And when he heard it, he was like, what is that? He was like, that sounds like some old James Brown funk right there. That's what that is. And then we was practicing one day, we were playing, we was coming back to the band room, then I stood up on the chair and said, the chant, let me say, all right, all that, the band started singing. Next thing I know, we got the football games, we're coming off the field, and the whole stadium saying, I'm like, oh my goodness. And so now to see it still going on so many years later, it warms my heart. I just want to say I love y'all. G-Hi.
Hi. We love you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
That's right.
When we hear that sound, we see you also. Mike Roberts,
Let us all stand and salute you. And thank you. And thank you. One last thing, y'all can sit back down. One last thing, I can't forget our beautiful children, man. I do everything for them. They're going out there all my life. They're all sacrificing. All my children that are here, will you please stand and let them see the world. Yeah. All y'all are the parents, you know there's no handbook for being a parent. There's no handbook for being a parent. We all do it the best way we get through it, the best way we can.
That's right.
And I just want to thank, them because they were the first persons in my face when I got the news. They all was in their cars on the way to see me. I love y'all. I love y'all.
Thank you. All right, here we go, here we go. Who counted up? Who we going? Theme one? Theme one. Come on, drum major.
One, two, three, go! Thank you. Thank you. I still play Sept.